Hello, my quilting friends. My name is Leah Day, and this week I am exchanging my foot pedal for the Janome 1600 with a speed controller. What this does is it sets my machine speed to be a steady, constant speed. So I no longer have to press the foot pedal. I can just simply press a button here on the speed controller and be able to focus only on moving my machine on the frame. So let's get started learning how to attach this device and how to use it. The first step to setting up your speed controller is to plug it in, and this goes into the plug for your foot pedal. So just unplug your foot pedal and plug in that cord. And then I like to take the cord and twist it around this arm of my carriage. And I'm left-handed, so I'm going to wrap this around this left side of the carriage. If you are right-handed, I would advise wrapping it around the right side of the carriage. So here is the speed controller for the Janome 1600. We've got our speed control dial on top. We've got an on-off button in the middle and a pulse button on the bottom. Now, you might be wondering about a thread cutter button. The thread cutter button only comes on the speed controllers for Juki sewing machines. Certain Juki sewing machines will have this thread cutter button here on top, but not all machines have that. So the Janome 1600 does not have that feature. As you can see, you only have those two buttons and the dial. So that's what it's going to look like. Now, I personally prefer it to be mounted like this, so that way I have my pulse button on top and my on-off button in the middle like this, my speed control on the bottom. That's just my personal preference. You can definitely play with this. This is something that's going to take some practice in order to figure out how you like it mounted to your machine best. Okay, I have opened up the Velcro and made those loops really nice and big and loopy, so that way I can take the whole thing and slip it down over that handlebar. And the handlebar is also something, that location, this can be moved. You know, I can have it down here, I can have it towards the back, I can have it pulled this way. I can put these handlebars anywhere I want them. So that's also something to play with, experiment, and see what works best for you. Okay, so I looped that cord over that bar, and now I'm just going to take that end, plug it in. We're ready to turn on the machine and start using the speed controller. So I've turned on my machine and I've set it up so that the needle is always ending in the down position. That's a button here on this side of the machine. So when I hit the pulse button, it's basically going to do a needle up, needle back down again. If I want the needle to end in the up position, I have to reach forward, hit that button on my machine in order to bring that needle up. If I hit pulse again, it's going to go down, back up again. Sometimes it might even take actually two stitches. So just keep that in mind. The pulse isn't going to be a needle down to needle up. It's going to actually be a pulse, like a locking stitch almost. So I'm going to have that where the needle is ending in the down position because that's how I mostly like to quilt. There we go. And now the on-off button is going to turn the machine on and it's going to stitch at a steady rate. Whatever I've set here on this knob is the speed that the machine is going to run. The speed slider here on the front of the machine doesn't really have much to do with that. I mean, you could play with it and play with the two in conjunction with one another if you want to, but it's not really necessary because you have the speed control right here in this dial. So I'm gonna hit on, and you have to kind of hit it and hit it hard in order to make the button go. And you can see that is really fast. So I actually wanna slow it down a little bit because if you're going really, really fast, then you're gonna need to move your hands faster. And as you can see, that needle is definitely going up and down fairly quick, but I'm pushing the carriage and moving it around not super fast. I'm not moving this just pedal to the metal. It's a slow, steady speed and movement of the machine around, and I'm just trying to keep that steady. I'm not making wild movements faster or slower. I'm just trying to keep that movement of my hands on the carriage the same because, of course, my needle speed is staying the same. A speed controller is not a stitch regulator. The only thing that we're doing is we're just making the controls of the machine convenient here on the handle of the handlebar. We can control it. Like I can sometimes speed it up, slow it down with my thumb as I'm steering the machine around if I'm really thinking about it. And it's just mostly a convenience factor more than anything else. But the speed of the machine moving is going to remain constant. Whatever is set up here, that's going to be the speed that the machine is stitching. So all of the work, as far as the stitch length goes, maintaining good looking balanced stitches, all of that work is going to be coming in with balancing that hand movement of moving the carriage slow and steady in relation to that machine movement. So here we go again. Let me just show you some examples. It's going to start out pretty fast. Let's slow that down again. All right, so let's say I move my hands really fast. I'm just swirling it around just as fast as I can possibly go. Well, my stitches are going to get really big. No matter if my machine is just pedal to the metal going super, super fast or not, if my hand movement is really fast, I'm going to get some really big stitches. And let's slow this down. Same way, if my machine is running really slow and I move my hands, you know, at a moderate rate, I'm going to get big stitches too. So if your goal is nice, small, consistent stitches, then you're going to want the machine to go a little faster than that. And you're going to want your hands to move fairly slow. So this looks good. This is a nice balanced stitch. They're not too big, not too small. It's like Goldilocks stitch. That's what I'm going for. So let's take a closer look at those stitches. As you can see here, when I move really slowly but run the machine at a fairly fast rate, my stitches get really small. And personally, I don't think there's such a thing as too small stitches. I think it's far more distracting when the stitches are too big. So that comes from moving your hands too fast. See how much bigger those stitches got? Very, very large. So you just have to remember, when using a speed controller, just a slow, steady movement. Keep your hands moving smooth and slowly, nice and steady. You're not making any wild movements, wild jerks, anything like that. Just a slow, steady movement. And really, I think designs like this is sharp stippling. This is a great choice for a starter design because you don't have to worry about travel stitching or stitching over a line of quilting. Just a nice, smooth transition. Make those sharp points. Very good design to begin with. So this speed controller is compatible with the Janome 1600, and there are many other machines that it's compatible with. You'll need to check the website at leahday.com/speed in order to see if your sewing machine is compatible with this device. If it's not, remember, you can continue using your foot pedal. Set it up underneath your frame, more or less in the middle, and operate pressing the foot pedal and then steering your machine. It takes a little bit to get used to, certainly. It takes some practice, but it also takes practice to use a speed controller too. With every quilt that you stitch on your hoop frame, you're gonna get better. So stick with it, keep practicing, keep quilting mini quilts. So my name is Leah Day. If you are interested in anything that you saw in this video, from the speed controller, the Janome 1600, or the hoop frame, you can come and check it all out at leahday.com. Until next time, let's go quilt.